Joining us now is Sameet Chavhan, technical analyst from Angel Broking. Sameet, at 10,570, what is the trade on the Nifty?
Hi, it seems that market has slipped into a consolidation mode after seeing a massive correction from the levels of 11,100 in such a short span. At least for a time being, 10,300, 10,350 has become a very strong support zone, and from there, in last 3 days, we have already witnessed a decent recovery. This recovery might extend a bit. Now it has reached its important resistance zone, so 10,620 is the level to watch out for. Once Nifty breaks this important support level, then probably we could see this relief rally getting extended toward 10,700 or 750 also. But as of now, this important resistance level would act as a very strong hurdle. As far as trading strategy is concerned, probably for a day or two, you can go long if Nifty gives a minor dip, probably toward 10,550. I won't take major stop losses at current level, at least on the long side. 10,520, 10,500 would act as a very strong support, and I would expect a decent up move at least toward 10,620. If Nifty struggles around 10,620 or 630, I would be a contra seller also.
Right, that's the call coming in on the index. What about Bank Nifty, Sameet? We didn't expect that they would do their bit, at least in the morning session, but it seems like as we progress through the day, Bank Nifty is pulling back quite well. At the day's high point, the 25,600 nearly on Bank Nifty. Any sort of trades could be initiated here on Bank Nifty itself?
See, probably, Friday was the correct time as far as, entry for Bank Nifty is concerned. 24,800, 24,700 acted as a very strong support for Bank Nifty, and from there we saw a decent recovery. So risk to reward ratio wise, 25,100 was a trigger point at least for a relief rally. So that become a good trade setup on the long side, say for a target of 25,500, 25,700. Now it has almost reached its important resistance, first 25,600 and then 25,800. So we would be closely watching this important resistance levels. But what we believe is the overall indices have now slipped into a consolidation mode. The weekly trend remains bearish, so this is still a sell on rise kind of market, and at higher levels you are likely to see some kind of selling pressure. But before that, this is probably is a consolidation mode wherein you are likely to see some kind of time-wise consolidation. So at this juncture, our strategy would be to focus on individual stocks that are likely to give decent bounce backs.
Right, that's the view coming in on Bank Nifty. IT, Sameet, is underperforming the index today on expected lines, especially after the kind of run-up the sector has seen in the last week's trading session. But this morning, would you consider sort of adding some positions in IT because it's giving you a chance to do so? Stocks like NIT Tech, Tech Mahindra, KPIT, even the frontline names like TCS, Infosys are looking somber. Would any of these stocks be good buys today?
Obviously, this is a kind of index balancing that we generally see. Banking is doing well, the other sector indices are doing well. So at the same time, you are seeing some kind of breather from IT as well as pharma sector. But if we look at it from a slightly broader perspective, clearly the IT pack as a whole looks quite good, and from here on we expect a decent up move in the entire space. From the large cap name, we like HCL Tech, which has already given a decent recovery from its important support levels of 900-910. So we believe that the HCL Tech would be a potential buy at current level. 965-968 seems to be a very strong resistance, but looking at its overall price action in last 3-4 days, we expect this breakout to happen soon. So we would rather go long on HCL Tech, keep a stop loss somewhere around 942 on a closing basis, and we would expect a decent up move probably towards say 990-995.
Sameet, what about NIT Tech? Last week it made that move from 840 all the way down to 740, and in the last 4 days it's pulled back again to levels of 840. This morning we're back at 830. On NIT Tech, is this looking like a buy at these levels to you? Because it is showing signs of resilience, right?
See, clearly this has Yes, sir. Clearly, this has been one of the outperforming stocks within this space since last 5 to 6 months. It has already given massive appreciation from low levels. However, since last 3 to 4 weeks, this stock has slipped into a consolidation mode, and which was quite evident also after seeing such a sharp rally. At least in the near term, 850 seems to be a very strong resistance, and if you see today's high also, it made somewhere around 848. So 850 seems to be a very strong hurdle, at least in the near term. So we would be a buyer in this stock once it breaks 850, not before that. We see this stock moving in a range of 850 to 750 first, and once it surpasses 850 on a sustainable basis, you could see a good move towards 900-905.
Right, that's the view coming in on NIT Tech. Samit, what are you doing with auto stocks? You're seeing some buying emerging in today's day of trade, largely ahead of those auto numbers that will start trickling in as we get towards the weekend on Wednesday, Thursday. And more importantly, auto ancillary is a space that's for buying on Thursday, Friday itself. I mean, stocks like Apollo Tyres were trying to hold on quite well. On auto ancillary, any preferences here?
See, within this space, we have been liking Tata Motors, and we have been a contra buyer since last couple of weeks, and we were expecting some kind of relief rally in Tata Motors, Tata Motor DVRs, last series also, but it didn't happen, and the stock underperformed and closed around its 52-week low. But on Friday also, we took a contra buy in this particular counter, somewhere around 362, 363, and we were expecting some kind of bounce back. So today the bounce back has come, and looking at the weekly chart, now the stock is trading around its multi-year support lows, which is placed around 355, 360. So from here on, Tata Motors remains to be our top bet within this space, and we expect this stock to give a decent relief rally towards 380, 385. So minor intraday dip would be a good buying opportunity in Tata Motors. So one can keep a stop loss somewhere on 358 and expect a decent up move toward 380-85. The same trade setup we can see in Tata Motor DVR also. 200 seems to be very strong support. So any minor dip in this particular counter remains to be a good buying opportunity for a target of say 218-220.
Right. Also, anything in the PSU banking space that, or in the private sector banks that you like? So would you be considering buying some of these mid-cap banks that are actually holding out quite well?
The entire PSU banking space gave a massive correction after the PNB fiasco. So overall trend remains bearish, and obviously after seeing a massive correction in such a short span, the entire space was quite extremely oversold. So some kind of bounce back was on cards, and we are seeing that bounce back in last couple of days. But we don't want to get into this particular space, at least for a short term view, because at higher levels you are likely to see some strong selling pressures. So within banking space, if we have to play in this particular bounce back, then Kotak Mahindra would be our preferred pick, which has been outperforming since last couple of weeks and has already given a decent rally. So risk reward wise also, this stock seems to be a better bet as compared to its other peers. We expect Kotak Bank to retrace its recent highs of 1120. So one can buy at current level, use any minor dip to go long, keep a stop loss somewhere around 1078.
Spotlight. Samit, we've already talked about a few sectors that are in focus, but what are you doing with pharma names? Sun Pharma, Dr. Reddy's, are these even on your radar to sort of go out and initiate long trades on?
See, as far as pharma space is concerned, we have been quite selective within this space. Yes, Sun Pharma has been one of our preferred bets, despite the fact the stock has become quite volatile in last couple of weeks time. The stock has corrected also from higher levels, but we remain quite bullish on this stock, and as long as this particular stock remains above 500, any dip would be a good buying opportunity according to us. With a slightly broader view, we expect this stock to surpass its hurdle of 600-610 quite soon. So we would be bullish on Sun Pharma. Use any dip to go long, and we expect a decent position in this particular stock. First 600 and then probably towards 640.
Right. And in your opinion, Sameet, what are your top stock recommendations? Can we firstly start with stocks that you would recommend, maybe where you're expecting a price volume breakout in today's day itself, or you know, stocks that we could sort of look at trading for the rest of the week?
See, within this space, we can get a decent bounce back in individual stocks, so we are focusing on such kind of counter. Indigo is the one stock that has given a decent breakout from its important hurdles. And in the morning, as a disclosure, we have recommended this to our clients around 1300. The stock has already spiked up a bit. But from current level also, if you see, this stock has a potential to move higher. 1360 would be our immediate target. And you know, once this stock surpasses 1360, you could see extension of this rally towards 1375, 1380 also. Tata Motor we have already discussed. Apart from this, you know, Tata LX is the one stock that we are liking. After a consolidation of nearly couple of weeks, today we are seeing a good price volume breakout from a resistance of 1030. So this stock is likely to extend this rally. 1080, 1085 would be our immediate target. One can buy with a stop loss of 1022. And on the short side, we are liking Asian Paints. This stock has been underperforming since last couple of days, and the entire broader market benchmark index has already given a decent recovery in last 2 days. But this stock is underperforming, and it is on the verge of giving a breakdown from a support level of 1090. So we would anticipate this breakdown, and one can go short at current level, keep a stop loss at 1025. We expect this stock to slide towards 1050.
Right. Along with that, anything in the metal space that you like right now? I mean, Vedanta, Tata Steel, even some of these mid-cap metal names seem to be in a breakout.
See, honestly speaking, despite the fact, you know, Tata Steel has already given a decent recovery in the last 2 days, we are not that bullish on this particular counter. We see possibility of, you know, selling pressure coming in at a higher level. 695-700 seems to be a very strong resistance according to us. So as a contra trader, we would rather go short in Tata Steel at current level. We'll keep a strict stop loss somewhere around 698. That would become a breakout point. And you know, once this stock slides below today's low, which is 679, you could see retesting of 660, 655. So we are not convinced with you know, last 2 days recovery. As long as this stock remains below 700 on a closing basis, it becomes a, you know, contra sell candidate for us.
Right. What are you doing with real estate names? Spotting any trend there, Sameet?
See, within the real estate space, clearly DLF is the one stock that we are liking on weekly as well as monthly chart. But at least in the short term, we expect some kind of consolidation happening. If we have to take any trade setup in this particular counter, at least with the short term view, then probably we'll wait for a breakout to happen beyond 234. So that seems to be a very strong resistance, at least in the near term. So if we have to go long on DLF, we would rather wait for a breakout to happen. Once it surpasses 234, we can see a good relief move towards at least 248-250.
Right. Thanks, Sameet. Good talking to you this morning. That's the market verdict coming in on the street, and of course, trading ideas from Sameet Chauhan. With that, we're completely out of time on FNO Spotlights. Thanks for watching. But while you take